Do you feel the urge to go off and make a, you know, American musical comedy or to do something that's completely outside of the historic genre? Or are you just really happy?
You know what? When I think about this, I don't really necessarily see the distinction between historical things and contemporary, because the contemporary is only contemporary very briefly. Mm-hmm. And next day it's history, you know. So yeah, I'm interested. I'm writing a 60s thing, mm-hmm. you know, and that's history. But to me, I mean, I lived through that, so it's not, it's, you know, it's, but it's also still alive and living part of my personal experience. So I think that to some extent it's a false dichotomy. And what I'm pleased to have done, if I've helped to do this, is to make a lot of Americans more open to this idea that history isn't, doesn't just belong in a museum, you know. Because I couldn't believe it for ages and ages that Americans weren't even interested in their own history. And it's like, oh, we don't have a history. What? You know, it's a really interesting history. I mean, I'd love to do more stuff about American history.
Yeah, we don't like to think about it too much.
No. Funny. Well, hey, you know, Henry Ford said history is bunk. But that
when things are going well, you just kind of want to, you know, ride the Big Mac or whatever.
Yeah. But the past is still your personal past. Is still part of your present, and your cultural past is still part of the present. So, you know, I can only enrich your life to be aware of that, he said pompously. After half an hour, I do start getting really pompous.
We all do.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure. Thank
Appreciate
you.
It.
Okay.